This is Podbeck, not a normal actor. I got the actor, brand new mates in the building, episode number 15. And we are just going to analyze whatever is happening in Kenya right now. Today, Leon Itare, 27th. 27th. Oh, first of all, how did you end up here, man? Like, as a country, to mefika jihapa, like, to mejipata jihapa. Mali, tension kwa wakanti mzima, people are saying today might be the last day of the president. Kuna nyo anasema, first of all, tumeshinda kweli?
So, according to me, jana, venye president ali peana nini yake, speech yake, na Regiji pia kapeana yake, nilijua tumeshinda. But waking up today and analyzing both the speeches, na feel tumechezwa.
Now, in terms of speeches, there were three speeches that nataka tuangele. There was the first speech, enye Ruto alipatiana juzi usiku. There was the second speech, ikapatiana jana. Then there's the third speech ya Rigiji. We start with the first speech. Yake ya 9 o'clock, whereby it was 7 minutes long. And it was, according to me, full of rage, hasira, and
to tell you the truth, that was the real Ruto, the one who spoke on Tuesday night, Tuesday 9 p.m. That was the real Ruto. Unavile alikuja na hasira mingi, and I'm so sure he was not advised by anyone other than maybe Farouk Kibet and the likes, because any sane person who saw what happened that day, including the UN,
everyone,
and gave their statements on the same, would have toned down the attitude. Akuje na a lot of remorsefulness.
Na unge pole.
Na unge pole pole. Don't talk at us. Like, talk to us.
In that speech, one of the things that you stand out ni alisema, whatever was happened that day, the day that people invaded parliament was, for lack of a better word, that was treasonous.
That was not treasonous. Treason is when we are trying to overthrow you from your throne. But that was not treason. That is a public property. And when people are making legislations, they're making those legislations on our behalf. Nifanya sisi wote atoshia kwa hiyo bunge 50 million plus people. So we donate our powers to some of these people, though waende wa legislate on our behalf. And that is why every bill that passes through parliament has to go through public participation. Kwa sababu it is for the public. Unajua, before it becomes a law, it has to be through the public. Yeah.
According to someone, treason is an offense against the people. And that particular day, the people could not have committed treason because it was not against themselves. It was just watu walikuwa wanataka tukusalimia MP kidogo tu.
Na hata ikukua ilikuwa tu ni statement. Unajua hata hakuna MP angepigwa pale. Unajua hivyo? Hakuna MP angepigwa. Issue ilikuwa tu ni ku make statement that if you want to get to State House, if you want to get to whatever building that we want to get to,
we will get to
those buildings. We will get to those properties. That was the statement. And it was also a wake-up call to the MPs. That means sisi tumawapatia hii power yote. Unafeel, unatembea na TX, whatever, fuel, gas, love, yenyewe unatumia. Sisi ndo tumedonate our powers to you. Tunakulipa na pesa zetu. You don't have money.
True.
Is our money that we have given you. To make sure that this process of you legislating, you representing us, it goes smooth on your end.
True. Najua? On that particular day, Pia, that short speech, ungemsoma alikuwa na hasira, and Ruto said he was going to find the planners, financiers, and arbitrators of that of yesterday's protest. One thing that stood out was that nobody planned the protest. Young people decided they'll all protest evening Tuesday and Thursday. It is our right to kuandamana too. So, Nashanga, why did he come and said that he was going to find the planners and the financials of that protest?
Last time when we were shooting, I gave you stages of this demonstration.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what will happen from us and what will happen to us?
Mm-hmm.
Number one was they will dismiss us. They will try to sell fear. They will try to tear gas us and arrest us,
mm-hmm.
which they did on the first day of the demonstration on Tuesday. We were actually very lucky. We were not arrested or beaten. On Thursday, now people were angry and everyone came last week Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe not everyone, but 50% of the people that would have wanted to come came out. And when that happened, now the government knew things were not going to be easy.
Mm.
So the second step was finding out who are the mobilizing, who are promoting and abducting them.
Mm.
We, for a minute, we went to a very dark place in, as a country.
Dark.
Because people like Boni, people like Osama Otero, Betweep, were abducted. People like Ogonda, and he's actually a government employee.
Yes.
Under the parliament.
And the only thing he does is just to tweet. Gabriel Yeo tweeted.
Yeah. Mm. So people like those, now, because their notion was this could be the finances. Oh, this could be the link to the finances.
Mm-hmm.
The link to the perpetrators, the link to the demonstrators.
Mm.
But they found out, no, they weren't. It was a people-based initiative. And after Thursday, the government was not backing down. And in fact, they came up with some flimsy, how do you call them, amendments that angered the people.
And then Nikapitishwa within a record of, within 2 hours.
Yes.
No bill has ever been passed that quick.
Yeah, so people are not given time to like debate properly. Mm. And if you stood to debate, you were echoed, you were booed, and all these other things.
Mm. So Bona President Akama Semati, this thing was treason, because someone defined treason.
Mm.
Even treason is when you steal our taxes.
Mm.
Treason is when you abduct people from their homes and detain them without trial.
Mm.
Treason is calling peaceful demonstrators
criminals.
Treason. Treason is shooting people in the head for protesting. Treason is stealing an election. Yo, first of all, same to E, shooting people in the head. That thing scared me to death. Because it was a sniper, I mean, feature somewhere, picking out people one by one. And that could have been any of us, man. Imagine.
It was so sad. Because that will sniper little weapon a chopper.
Man, that means... It was
premeditated.
They knew
what was coming their way. They knew they had planned it.
That second speech, Ruto,
mm-hmm.
alikuja kama meton down. First of all, you cannot lecture us the previous night, then come and you cannot call us criminals, then come the second day and call us
your sons
and daughters.
No.
Then come and lie with a straight face that only 6 people died. And then you say that 6 people... Ni kama si kitu ni si watu
ni watu sita tu,
like
you know, we hata tungekuwa hapo in the first place, kwa sababu after the first demonstration ukatoshika, tukarudi bado the second demonstration, tukarudi bado hiyo Tuesday hii wiki. By the time we were doing the third demonstration, na ukaona every Kenyan was outside, like ungeita tu press conference utuambie ni aje, just call it off. Nimekubali, wachani hiyo nini bill ni irkatae, irudi bunge.
In fact, before people even invaded parliament, watu walikuwa wengi sana. In your own wisdom, ungeita tu nini, hata tuone press conference wakiwa town, like, hey, wait, president amesema.
Alafu, I'm a very bitter person today, having to agree with someone like Rigathi Gachagua. Like, I feel so bad that I'm agreeing with him.
Like this government has made Rigathi a savior, like aje man.
Alafu, NIS, walikuwa wanajua the magnitude of the people, wana monitor our social media activities. Kuna vitu zinaitwa algorithms. Walikuwa shangalia through the algorithms wakajua, hey bro, whatever is coming tomorrow is bad.
And according to Rigathi Gachagua, that the rejection of the finance bill was started 2 months ago.
Yes.
The NIS had intelligence, but they never told the president. Do you know why? The president is never in the country.
According to Rigathi.
Yes.
And also Pia, this president cannot be advised. I don't feel like he's so self-righteous.
Kabisa.
I feel like he's so self-righteous. Yenye, akisema hii ndo njia tutaenda nayo inafaa kwa hiyo ndo njia.
Because even his second speech was not saying I'm sorry. No. Was simekatani wafanyie kitu mzuri.
Yeah. Alafu kama uli watch hiyo nini vizuri, ungeona tu IMF written all over his face.
Yes.
Unajua? It was IMF. Alafu IMF was arrogant enough to tell Kenyans that the solutions for the demonstrations lies within Nairobi.
And we all know that's a lie.
And we all know that was a lie.
Ruto also said that ever since he came into office, there has never been an incident of extrajudicial killings. Kwani this guy is out of touch with reality. Aje, for you to make such a statement.
But now the SSU is back. The SSU is back. The people who are being abducted. See, they were abducted by the SSUs. Unasikia mpaka dem alipelekwa place amefungiwa kwa choo.
Man,
in a forest. You tell me, how would you take someone to a forest? Ati kwa nyumba iko tu kwa forest. You have properties in forests, bro, where you just want to torture people and abduct them as you wish. Because they have a different opinion from yours.
So people are still feeling we are back to 1992. That after this comes down, that people will be picked one by one by one by one.
Yeah.
Someone said this. Kwa space ya jana, Zakayo ameshuka, lakini amekaa hapo chini ya mti anangoja tu watu waende. Arudi juu na pande mti tena.
Haina shida. Unajua hata sisi hatuna job. Like, kitu tuko nayo ni time.
Wewe ukishuka tuko
tu.
Ukirudi kupanda ni. Mimi feel ameshuka, honestly speaking. Na feel tu amwambia watu, si mnaona ndio mimi nakuja. Like it's a songeni nishuke, but si feel kama ameshuka.
So number one, we are not going back to the dark days za nini.
Sure.
Na we are not kwa sababu right now, unajua yote ya wazazi wetu hakukuwa na simu, smartphone, nini. Unajua? Hakukuwa na hizo. Number two ni, people were not educated as they are right now. Jusayu wakikuja kutushika sisi hapa. Si tutatoka tu nje hapa, tupige nduru, tuseme mwizi.
Na wasawa tufuate hadi police station.
Na wasawa tufuate.
Wa demand amepelekwa police station guy.
Unajua? Like, what happened to akina nani? Akina Gabriel. Na daktari na Osama, si ni kelele zetu tu ziliwarudisha.
But have you
noticed, unajua time wasio walikuwa napotea na ujui utaanza kuuliza nani. Huwezi piga kelele mahali popote, wako na radio station moja. Ukienda kusema ati manze huyu mseto alipotea, haitatangazwa
kwanza, iko na protocol refu. Have you noticed watu wote wanakuwa abducted wakirudi they turn down?
Apart from Osama Otero.
Apart from Osama Otero. You see that name alone. Osama Otero. I wanted to get your opinion on this. Why will President Ruto claim that the finance bill 2024 was hijacked by dangerous criminals? Why would he say such a thing?
But who hijacked it? Kwa sababu every policy is made at the parliament.
So see, I think alikuwa anasema sisi.
So, ndo unasema. Si alitwitter tu. Criminals from the word go. So me, I don't feel anything absurd about it being called a criminal by the president who we elected.
Because kwani finance bill iko na nini yenye can't be rejected by.
So unaona yeye mwenyewe alisema jana that he is going to reduce on the expenditures, and then whatever we have been telling him, we have been asking him, live within our means. Alisema sasa we will live within our means jana. Na unaona hii ni conversation imekuanga all along. Bana Mr. President, you've never stayed this long in this country. This is like your third week. Na hata last week after maandamano, si alienda sijui alienda place last week after maandamano.
huo msee kwanza ni ndege tu ndo anapenda.
So tunasema hivi, tone down those trips. Kuna trips zingine you as the president ukiishia, it is very expensive, but ukituma tu msee kama minister,
but pia si lazima tuende. Si lazima tuende, sielewi nini iko President Ruto alikuwa na push sana for this bill to pass, because even Museveni has sent back the 2024-25 budget to the Ugandan parliament. He termed it as unfair to the people. Ni uoga, because whatever is happening
in
around
Kenya.
In Kenya ama in Africa?
No, in Kenya.
I feel it's in Africa.
We have inspired Africans now.
No. I don't think ni Kenya tumeanza hii movement.
Si ndo tumeanzisha hii movement. Look at it.
Because si Botswana did it. Ni Botswana ama ni country gani? Kuna countries kama nne zimekuwa ziki. Ni tu Kenya sasa tumei amplify, like it doesn't have to be through fights and what not. Nimeona Ghana pia wamepatia government yao 3 months notice. Ghana bana, you guys are giving 3 months notice to protest. 3 months notice to protest.
We amka tu enda kwa barabara. Just get up, go to the room.
3 months,
bana, government itawachukua.
Bro, 3 months ni mingi sana. Because hata a week notice, intelligence ya government itafikia tu na wajue ni wapi na nani na nini. Because 3 months, it means we are organizing ourselves.
Hiyo wachana naye.
So ya Ghana might not work. But ya Uganda, how do you feel about it? For Msevo to turn down.
Msevo?
As Msevo sense danger.
Msevo amejua the biggest population, young people. Looking at their own statistics. And looking at our own statistics as Kenyans. Amona, the majority
are
young people. Awa si watu nilikuwa nimezoea kutishia kina Kiza
Besigye na the rest.
Awa si yao. Kwa hawa sasa wakisema wanataka kuingia hii parliament, wataingia. Na saa hii vile international criminal courts ziko, wajakuwa na kesi mingi of late. Wanatamani tu sana anything of this sort it happen. So they are occupied na wanaangalia.
I wanted to know who told politicians that the only thing we eat is ugali. Because the whole president speech yake ya kwanza alianza ni the price of unga imerudi chini. Why do politicians believe that the only thing we take is ugali, that they will just fight for that? Bro, kamanda ni 300 saa hizi. Roskoko ilipanda juzi, sijui nini mbana hawa.
Alafu unaangalia price ya unga na uangalia hata kama umse anaweza afford hiyo price, una reduce it too. Unajua hauna job, hauna nini. People are surviving with less than 100 shillings a day. Less than a dollar. Mse anaamua I'll just have 1 mil and 1 mil alone.
Na hiyo 1 mil si guarantee.
Na hiyo 1 mil hata si hiyo ugali unasema. Kwa sababu unga si 100. Si ndio?
I just feel someone needs to tell these politicians that first of all you need to reduce salaries of politicians. Mimi sijui how it will happen, when, but we need to start by reducing MPs,
especially
presidents,
ministers.
Alafu we have so many posts zenye hazisaidi. Ukisikia cabinet secretary SES akona, sijuangi kazi ya PS ni nini?
Kazi ya PS sasa si ndio permanent secretary, yeye ana make sure that yeye unajua ni civil servant. Ana make sure that the ministry is working. He is the accountable senior most officer on ministry.
Kazi ya minister ni gani?
Kazi ya